dy by dx for the equation cos x whole raised to y equals sine y whole raised to x. Let us call this as equation 1. From equation 1 we have cos x whole raised to y minus sine y whole raised to x equals 0, and let us denote cos x whole raised to y minus sine y whole raised to x as f of x y, a function on variables x and y. Thus we have rewritten equation 1 in the form f of x y equals c, where c is a constant and here c equals 0. By theorem on implicit differentiation we have dy by dx equals negative fx upon fy. Let us evaluate fx, which is partial derivative of f with respect to x, treating y as a constant. When you partially differentiate the term cos x whole raised to y with respect to x, treating y as a constant, we have to make use of the rule d by dx of x raised to n equals nx raised to n minus 1. Here in place of x we have cos x and in place of n we have constant y. Thus we get the derivative as y cos x whole raised to y minus 1 into derivative of cos x, which is negative sin x. When you partially differentiate the second term sin y whole raised to x with respect to x, treating y as a constant, we have to make use of rule of differentiation d by dx of a raised to x equals a raised to x log a, where a is a constant. Here in place of a we have sin y, because y is treated as constant, and in place of x we have x itself. This derivative of sin y the whole raised to x partially with respect to x, treating y as a constant, is obtained as sin y raised to x into log sin y. Similarly, we have fy, which is partial derivative of f with respect to y, treating x as a constant, obtained by taking partial derivative of cos x whole raised to y, now treating x as constant, and hence cos x is constant here. So we have to make use of this rule. In place of a, we have cos x, which is a constant here, and in place of x, we have the variable y here, because differentiation is done with respect to y. Thus partial derivative of cos x whole raised to y with respect to y is obtained as cos x whole raised to y into log cos x. When you differentiate the second term sin y whole raised to x partially with respect to y, we will make use of this rule. Here we have x as a constant and x equals n here. In place of x we have function sin y, because y is treated as variable, and n, which is the constant here, n equals x. Therefore partial derivative of sin y whole raised to x is obtained as x sin y whole raised to x minus 1 into cos y. Now we can distribute negative sign to both terms in the numerator, and we get both terms in numerator becoming positive. Now we will replace sin y the whole raised to x by cos x whole raised to y. This is because by equation 1 we have sin y whole raised to x is exactly same as cos x whole raised to y. Now we can rewrite sin y whole raised to x minus 1 as sin y whole raised to negative 1 into sin y whole raised to x, where sin y whole raised to x can be replaced by cos x whole raised to y. Thus this expression is rewritten in this way by depending on equation 1. Now we have cos x whole raised to y, which is common to both terms in numerator as well as denominator, and it can be cancelled. The remaining terms are obtained as y tan x plus log sin y upon log cos x minus x cot y. Using the relation sin x by cos x equals tan x, and cos y divided by sin y equals cot y.